Rob Bentley with you. Final score, Ferris State wins it 97-91 in overtime. And joined now by the head coach of the Ferris State Bulldogs, Andy Brockham. And coach, certainly got to be proud of the way your team competed here today, but what a finish to this one.
Yeah, I don't really know what just happened. And it was exciting, and it was tormenting, and it was fun, and it was, you know, gut-wrenching, everything. It all just happened in one game, and, you know, we're very lucky to come out on top, and I'm proud of that. I'm happy for our players. I'm sad for the Ashland players. They have one of the classiest groups you'll ever meet, and they love competing against Wendell Davis, and it all trickles down from there, John, and they do things the right way. They deserve to win this game, but we were able to bank one in and, you know, carry that momentum into overtime and finish her off.
Talk about that last part of regulation. Obviously, they got a big three after Peter Furlick made the free throw from Drew Noble, but you drew it up, and Andrew Meacham able to find Furlick, and he hit an incredible shot to force overtime.
Yeah, we drew it up, and, you know, Pete has the option to pass there or, you know, shoot if he feels like it, and he got it where he needed to and launched it up and went in, but we know Meacham can throw the ball. That's what we practice. We know he's got the best arm, most accurate, so we put him in there, but, you know, just the shot they made with and that's kind of the game within the game. If you notice, he shot 10 threes, 3 of 10, and, you know, in order to stop some of the other things that they do, we've chose to play off them a little bit, you know. Clearly, I think everybody in the stands can see that, and, you know, it was just like it burnt us, you know. He made the big one, and I was willing to shake his hand and say congratulations on the big shot, but at the end of the day, he went 3 of 10, 30%, and it wasn't quite enough, so we won the gamble. I mean, the games within the games are great, and that kid's a fantastic player. He's going to be all league. If he's not this year, he'll be all league. He's only a sophomore. Kid we recruited to Ferris, and you know, he chose to come here, and this is a great place to go. But lots of things happening, and never say die. Wendell's going to come up and hit a couple threes to make it interesting, and got to go to the monitor and check out three or four plays. It was crazy, Robert.
Obviously, Wendell Davis, a senior for them, had a big game. On your side, one stage of the ball game, I think I looked at the score sheet in the second half, and Noah King, Marquise Mayfield, Drew Cushingberry had all been scoreless. Talk about their play down the stretch. Obviously, all three of them made some big plays for you.
Yeah, unfortunately, I wasn't able to decipher that on the fly. I wish I could have. You know, I asked a couple questions to our staff, and we just said, let's just stay the course here. It was a little odd. I'm pretty sure they were paying a lot of attention to those guys in certain ways, and I'd like to dissect that in case we see them again in the tournament. But, yeah, that's the give and take of basketball. You can take some people away if you put enough resources on them or if you guard them a certain way. That just makes other people more available. And it's like noon ball. When they double team me, you know, you're wide open, Robert.
Well, certainly here, some big plays in overtime. You're able to take control early in that overtime session. And what were some of the keys in that extra session?
I don't even know. I mean, the key was staying sane and composed. I mean, I saw Zach getting crazy. He was on the edge, most of the part on the good side of the edge. He's getting crazy. He deserved that technical. Next thing you know, I want to grab him, pull him back to the bench. I'm almost at half court. Ref turns around. I get a tee. And it was so that composure there was not good on Zach and my part. And I mean, we have to be prepared, you know, to shake the other team's hand one of these games and say, good job, you've beaten us. And they did everything they could. And they deserve to win, but somehow we came up with it.
Obviously, some veteran leadership on your team, and going on the road here, you're going to face some adversity, and you certainly faced some here today, but found a way to get the win.
Man, lots of adversity, and lots more stories we can share off the air, maybe. But it was a crazy game, and Ashland's got great basketball with the women's team and the men's team and the community. So just extremely happy to get this victory. And I honestly say, we were prepared to shake your hand and say, job well done, you've beaten us. And we beat them by quite a bit at our place, so you know they were practicing hard and really wanting to compete like they know they should. And we were ready to do that if we needed to, but tonight we didn't need to, so.
Obviously, you wrap up a road stretch here in Ohio, back-to-back wins over Tiffin and Ashland, a couple hard-fought games, and now off to the Upper Peninsula next week for two more big games here on the road.
Oh, big games, bigger than big. Each team playing for a lot up there, and we're playing for a lot, so probably going down to the wire like this and take some bank shots and some technical fouls and craziness to win or lose one of those games.
Well, Coach, congratulations again on a great win, 97-91 in overtime, and looking forward to talking to you again next week.
Thanks, Robert.
We'll be back with more of the Lake Osceola State Bank postgame show in 6.